Round one with mono green elves. Sounds fine. I'm sort of wishing that I picked up a second Llanowar Elves to boost my speed a bit. If I had known my deck was going to be this strong, then I would err on the side of speed and coming out smoothly over like late game power. Death Touch very good against Wall of Omens. So I guess I'm looking for my third land here. So first thing I'm going to do is attack with the archers, then I'm going to commune looking for a forest and play Wyrewood Symbiote. Oh, I misread this card. Boy, I'm sorry, guys. I thought this could find a land, but it's only creature or enchantment. Well, I could take Llanowar Elves. That's sort of like getting a land. Yeah, that's probably my best bet. Well, I don't think that would have changed the way I built my deck, but a few of the things that I said about commune with the gods being really nice, not true. Interesting, up against an enchantment deck. So here I could either play Timberwatch Elf or I could play Llanowar Elves Symbiote or Llanowar Elves Commune with the Gods. I think getting Timberwatch Elf into play is quite a big threat in this elf deck. It's going to put my opponent in a position of wanting to block that Thornwield Archer sooner rather than later. And remember, can double activate the Timberwatch Elf with Wyrewood All right, so I'm going to save the Chieftain for later, but I probably want to play these two guys. Maybe I want to commune first. Think I like the Huntmaster to set up a Centaur Chieftain down the road. And threatening to attack here for as much as 7. Think I'm just happy to make it 5. Okay, so this makes me discard every turn. No big deal there. I wonder how close I am to having lethal, actually. So, if I cast Centaur Chieftain, then I'll have 4, 7, 9, 11 power, plus this pumps for 3 is 14. And then I could activate it a second time with the symbiote. So if my opponent blocks incorrectly, I could win the game this turn. But thinking think I'm more excited to play it this way. Yeah, so let's pump Symbiote. And I think my opponent is forced into position to block anyway here. No, maybe not. Not quite. Maybe I blew it by playing that forest actually, because I have to discard. No, I can just discard Regal Force. That's fine. I don't think the game's going to get that far. It give haste also? No, it doesn't give haste, just trample. Baleful Strix, a really good card, but not going to save my opponent from the trample here. It's going to have to be a Wrath of God. When choosing targets, I have to target a Flag Bearer. Yep. So, Chieftain with Threshold and Swing. I guess. Of course, it's I deal more damage by tapping the Timberwatch Elf for its activated ability, but the game is very well over here. And I can still untap it with Wyrewood Symbiote if I want. All right. So, my opponent seemed to have a multicolor controlling deck with a bit of an enchantment theme, so I could think about bringing in the Black Splash. I think Roots seemed very bad. Nature's Claim, I guess, should definitely come in, right? Maybe Giant Solifuge will give my opponent some trouble. Try like this for now. Maybe Gravedigger. Maybe bring in some black cards. Gonna try it like this one more time. Probably could board out Maze of Ith reasonably against such a controlling deck. My hand's great, by the way. It's not the super explosive elf hand, but I just have 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop, a late game bomb. Ooh, Innocent Blood, all right. Archer down. Keep those lands coming. So let's see what my opponent can come up with. There's still a swamp in hand. I know that from the swamp cycling. No play. So that probably means the what's it called? Second thoughts card? No. Fact or fiction in my upkeep. Well, these are all kind of poor, honestly. The one I'd be most afraid of is Yavimaya Enchantress. So, Enchantress and Plains against the other three, something like that. All right, so took the Humble, Glacial Wall, and Forest. Now I'm coming in for five. And two more creatures means two more elf warriors. So we're in pretty good shape here. Quickly gonna put my opponent again to the test of board sweeper or no, especially with Regal Force on the horizon here. For game three, I'm gonna board out this Maze of Ith. I just don't need it. It's a good draw. The commune. Maybe I can find a symbiote. Well, Huntmaster's good too. I'm going to draw a lot of cards. The Regal Force. Have to maybe start worrying about decking myself. So here I can attack with Thornwield Archer, or I can leave it back to block, but I don't think my life total is a relevant force here. And here's an example too of where I could play Maze of Ith and attack with everything and just maze my own creature, whatever the opponent blocks. So maybe that value is enough that it's fine to keep Maze of Ith in the deck. Yeah, all these high toughness blockers are not really going to be enough against the army that's going wide here. Now, I think I'm actually just going to attack first. At the point where I'm drawing eight cards with a 19-card library, I'd probably rather draw seven cards than draw eight. I'm just going to have to discard a lot and don't want to be worried about decking myself. I have another Regal Force in my library somewhere, too. So, yeah, let me attack first, see what my opponent does, and then post-combat play Regal Force. Cool, so I get in some damage there. And post combat, play a 5/5 and draw some cards. Gonna be casting Commune with the Gods in this game, so I'll discard that and a couple forests. Well, safety first. Let's play out a symbiote. And a Maze of Ith. And come in big. And this should be lethal if my opponent doesn't have an instant. Oh, that works. Prevent my combat damage, sure. Now I want to play some guys, make some elves, but I want to also end the turn with a stacked hand, just in case my opponent does have Wrath of God or something like that. Now I'll return, think a Thorn-Wield Archer. And a Wayfinder, just to have them in my hand in case my opponent plays Wrath of God. That's not going to do it. Although it is a cantrip because of the Mesa Enchantress. So this is going to require another fog for my opponent to survive this turn. That's fine. Okay, on to round two.